devastation.
The number of displaced and missing continues to rise.
I was thinking, earthquake? What do you mean, earthquake?
I was scared and I started crying.
You ask yourself, why Christian? He doesn't deserve this. He's a good boy. Why?
I couldn't cry that time because I think I was in shock. It's hard to go through it again.
Going back home was a tough one because we weren't born with a silver spoon in our mouth. You have to wake up at dawn. You either go on fishing or you go to the farm. And living with my 10 siblings and other extended family members was tough. Christian, I'll say he loved football. He doesn't like waking up at dawn. Going on the river in that cold time is not good. He preferred to be on the field. At that time, if your child is always on the field, they see it as a stubborn kid. And Christian is always intelligent. But as a father, seeing your intelligent son always on the field, coming back late, you wouldn't be happy.
When I brought him to Accra here, he started playing with the children there when he was like 9, even from 8. Initially, I didn't support it because I was the one who was taking care of them. So then my intention to go to school, but he wanted to pray.
He was somebody who believed in himself. And he tells you he sleeps and he dreams that he's playing football. And at the point, you would think he's hallucinating. But as time goes on, we realized and got to understand what he was made of, what was in him, and what he wanted to do. He was very determined to play football.